Welcome to Desi Plaza TV. We have a guest today in our studio from Boston, Dr. Shivraj Tyagi. He was a former faculty member at the Harvard Medical School and currently director of research at a very outstanding biotechnology company. He was a born Hindu, but he, in his past life, this past years, had a lot of experience with many spiritual organizations, starting from Brahma Kumari, because his mother used to run Brahma Kumari Center in Delhi. He came across the Bhagavad Gita through the association with Arya Samaj. And he has been with Sant Nirankari Mission for over 25 years. His interest is to explore science and spirituality through various philosophies, religions, and coming across with the evolved souls. He is with us today. We look forward to hear from you, Tyagi Saab, about the Nirankari Mission. And you will first let us know, why are you here? What is your purpose of visiting Dallas?
Thank you, Desi Plaza TV and Dr. Harbans Lalji. I am so delighted and thankful for your invitation, and I am so happy. I am honored. I am humbled. I don't have word to express my gratitude, because today I am so overwhelmed, because the time we are spending here, next 15 minutes or half an hour, which we will discuss about real humanity, which we can correlate science and spirituality together. Today we are gathered here to discuss my recent means experience. Recent means last 25 years association with Sant Nirankari Mission, which I started in Atlanta, then I moved to Boston. Thank you.
Tyagi Saab, there was a Pew report recently which said that the adherence to religion is declining in this world for last over 10 years. Particularly the youth community is not subscribing to religions, and they are running away. So what do you think, what are the major aspects or feature of Nirankari Mission to stop this drain from the religions of the youth generation?
Thank you, Dr. Harbans Lalji. 2-3 years ago, when I came to Houston, same question was asked by two pastors. But I am reporting here, Sant Nirankari Mission is not that case, because in our Sant Nirankari Mission, we have seen youth are the most motivated saints in our Sant Nirankari Mission. But yes, I agree, because when you intermingle spirituality and religion, let me make it clear, Sant Nirankari Mission is a spiritual movement. It is not a religion. So that is the difference, and it we can correlate, because spirituality is just like a newly born child, and when we grow adult and old, so we get some layers of contamination. So that's why, because if we will remain pure, although most or all the religions are started from spirituality, so that may be one of the reasons, if you will remain spiritual, because it is universal. So if something is universal, people will like and will agree with our teachings of our mission, and that is one of the reasons. In our mission, young children are taking the active part. I think I have satisfied your question, Dr. Harbans Lalji.
You have in your past experience with several spiritual movements that I mentioned in the introduction. Would you describe as to how these spiritual movements can help each other and kind of integrate, and why what are the subtle differences?
Yes, I agree with your question, because it is the essence of today. Our motto or mission's message is universal brotherhood or universal humanity. It is only possible if we will have something common in all, because we have we are now 8.6 billion human beings over the on this planet, and all religions, as I have said earlier, started with spirituality, but later on they were walled themselves. So I'm giving you one quick example of most major religions of the world. I'm giving you Hindu, Muslim, Sikh, Isai, Buddhist, Jain, Parsi, Jews, and so forth. For major thing, if you are a Hindu, if you are kind-hearted, then certainly you are a good Hindu. If you are having Iman or truth, then you are a good Muslim. If you have good service habits, you are a good Sikh. And if you have tolerance and kindness, then Sikhism. And if you evaluate yourself, that is Buddhism. If you have a Nirvana and a good Mukti, then Jainism, and so forth. So in Santana Kali Mission, we have all these above I just said, because we practice in satsang. We are kind enough. The satsang itself is a satsang, means the congregation of truth, and Satguru, who is teaching only the truth. So, and then third, whatever service we do, it is a selfless service. And then finally, we are tolerant and then kind-hearted. So, and then we are evaluating ourselves just like Buddha said. So it is a bouquet. Instead of having single flower, so we have a combination of all these religions, all good things. So I hope I justify your question very well.
But what is the religion, what is the reason that today, on this very day, there are 43 wars going on in this world, and all of them have their basis on religion?
Yes.
The religion is the cause of 43 wars going on.
Yes.
Today's world.
Yes. So you are absolutely right. Most of the wars or killings or destruction is because of religions. Because as I said, all religions started from the spirituality, but later on my way or highway. Because they don't see other religion good thing. All religions have something good in them. But we evaluate only our religion is the best. Rest is may not be that good. So I'm giving you one example. If you take the example of dollar bill, if it is originally printed on one side and other side is blank, so it doesn't have any value. So we should evaluate ourselves, but ready to listen other religion as well, and then take the best of it. So that's why Nirankari Mission is doing that thing. So Babaji's message is universal brotherhood, oneness with harmony. So that is only possible if you will do your selfless seva, you remember this Almighty God, and then do regular satsang, which is a more practical way to practice in daily life.
But so, none of the founders of any world religion said that the people should fight among themselves. So where did all that start? How did we go away from what our forefathers told us, people who started the religions?
Yes, because as you know, Dr. Harbanslal ji, if you see the history of Indian culture or Indian tradition, although we don't know the exact history, but we do see or read from the history, we have this 5 to 10,000 years of history. So Hinduism is not a religion. It is a way of life. It is a philosophy. Nobody can claim, I started Hinduism. Same thing, 2005 years ago, Gautam Buddha was not Buddhist. Buddhism started from there. Same thing with Jainism, the contemporary at that same time. He was not Jain. Jainism started from there. 2000 years ago, Jesus was born and he was not Christian, but Christianity started from there. Then 1500 years plus, Muhammad was born. Islam was not there, or Muslim was not there. He was not Muslim, but Islam started. Same thing, more than 500 years ago, Baba Nanak born, and then Dasam Gurus. So those did not born in that religion, but they started that. And then finally, you need a live guru or live teacher to teach the real thing, because the holy books are good, but you sometimes superpower on the holy books. So that's why sometimes we don't read, because we don't have that much time to read other religions book. if you are means well informed, just like Vivekananda, he was means well informed Hinduism, of course, but for other religions as well. And he presented Eastern philosophy in Chicago in 1893. Yeah. So you can imagine, like, if he can do more than 150 years ago, so today is really, it is the need of today. So that's why we are here to discuss how Nirankari Mission can bring people together.
You know, it reminds me when Guru Nanak visited Saudi Arabia, Makkah. He was asked about over 300 questions, and one important question they were asked, which is important to me, they asked him, what is your religion? Because he was wearing Muslim clothes, he was in Makkah doing Hajj, but he was born in India. To them, anybody from India is a Hindu, so they say, what is your religion? And his answer was, I am man of God, I have no religion. And that,
so
there is something to it. Yeah.
Very true, because this Sant Nirankari Mission is following up. Sant Nirankari Mission is not religion, as I said early on, it is a religion of humanity. So we practice spirituality. So we are human being of spiritual experience. So I fully agree, whether you take the teachings of Bhagavad Gita or Krishna, who said, do your karma, means everything is in me and everything belongs to me. So same thing Baba Nanak means gave this message to the world, like, you have to fulfill your family responsibility and then teach this spirituality. And when he was means alive, there were very many followers, but more followers are now. Even you take the example of Ram or Krishna or Jesus or Baba Nanak or Muhammad Sahib, we are more followers today, but when they were alive, there were not many followers at that time. So Baba Nanak was the live example. You quoted Dr. Harbans Lalji. Yeah. Thank you.
Just a friendly criticism. Why do you do not use a gender neutral term instead of brotherhood?
Yes, you are absolutely right. I am thinking on, and I already suggested, like, it should be universal humanity or universal brotherhood and universal sisterhood.
Or kinship, universal
yes.
Kinship.
Yes, kinship is equally good. Thank you for your input.
So, what are the practical ways, in your opinion, that we can approach people of different religion, particularly the extremist and fanatic aspect of the religion, to make them realize that they are not on the path what their founders showed them?
Yes. Well,
what are the means and ways that we can approach them?
Because I can give you a little bird's eye view. I hear and I forget. I see and I remember. I do and I understand. So when somebody criticizes some means a religion or a spiritual movement, they should come and attend the congregation. Then they will find themselves whether means we are teaching or the means spiritual movement are teaching the means humanity to world over. I am giving you one example. When I was visiting Maryland National Institute of Health, I invited some of my friends, can you attend or would you like to attend Sant Nirankari Mission congregation today? Yes, they agreed. And when they came, they were standing in the back benches because they were thinking, this turban fellow may be sick. But when Babaji started his discourse, they sat down because they have seen by their eyes. And then they listen. So they act.
Okay. Finish the sentence.
Okay. Use their brain. And then finally, when they were there by the end of the discourse, then they touch their heart, they sit down in the front row. Mm-hmm. So that is a good example. They should come and see what's going on in this particular congregation.
We'll have a short break. We'll be back soon.